Hi Riley, I hope you're doing well. It's Miss Weeby from Mrs. Doggett's class. Today I'd like to show you how to make this painting. It's a jar of fireflies and at the top it says shine bright. So I hope you enjoy. As you make this watercolor, you are going to need watercolor paints. You're going to need a soft, large watercolor brush. You're going to need a cup full of water, one white crayon, and one black marker, and one white piece of paper. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to take your white crayon and you're going to make three small circles in the middle of your paper. They can be different sizes, they can be the same sizes. You're going to make three circles in the middle of your paper. And you may not see the circles right away, but if you tilt your paper a little bit, you should be able to see where they are on the paper. Then you're going to take your paintbrush, you're going to dip it in your water, and you're going to get all of your paints wet. Once you've done that, you're going to dip your paintbrush in your yellow paint. You're going to get it all nice and wet. And you are going to paint over your white circles. And then they should start showing up on your paper. Oopsie, I missed my white circle, but that's okay. Right, so your paint should look up like mine, three yellow puddles. Then you're gonna clean out your brush. And you're going to dip your brush into your blue paint. Make sure your blue paint and your brush are both very wet. And then you're going to go around your yellow circles. And you're going to just touch them with the edge of your brush so that the yellow leaks a little bit into the blue. And you're going to paint all the way up to the edges of your paper. Alright Riley, your paper should be mostly dry by now. What you're going to do is you're going to take your black Sharpie, or black marker, black pen, and you are going to draw little fireflies inside each of your white circles. The way we're going to do that is we are going to draw a long, skinny body, and we're going to draw two antennae. And then we're going to draw two loops or sets of wings right on top of each other. They'll be overlapping. Just like that. If you want to draw some lines inside for your firefly's body, you can. I'm going to draw another one facing the other direction, long skinny body. Two loops that overlap, almost like a dragonfly. And then one more. Long skinny body, two overlapping loops for the wings. And then antennae, few lines across the body just to make it more interesting. Alright, then what we're going to do is we are going to draw a very long skinny oval across the bottom of the middle of our page. I'm going to think we're going to draw the jar around our firefly, so I'm going to draw the bottom of it about from here to here underneath the fireflies. Skinny oval, just like that. Then I'm going to draw one line from just over the top of the highest firefly and connect it down to one side of my oval. Then I'm going to draw another line on the other side. These are going to be the sides of our jar. And then I am going to draw a smaller loop right in between these two lines, a little bit above it. This will be for the lid. So right about there. Just like that. Then I'm going to draw two short lines that go down from the edges of our oval. And then I'm going to draw another line that matches this bottom part of the oval. So it'll be like half of an oval. Just like that. And then I'm going to connect the top of this line to the bottom of the jar lid in a little half circle. Just like that. Same thing on the other side. Just like that. Then for the lid for the jar, if you want to draw some lines going down, can just like that. Right? And then you are going to write the words "Shine Bright" across the top, all in capital letters. Shine Bright. You can also write it across the bottom if you want, in a semicircle. And then we're going to draw some shine lines because our fireflies are glowing. So we're going to draw some near the lid, draw a tall one right at the corner between where the lid and the jar meet, and then a shorter one on either side. Then you're going to draw another tall shine line and two shorter ones at the other corner of the lid and the jar. And then you're going to do the same thing for the bottom two corners. Tall line, two short ones next to it. Tall line, two short ones next to it. They can curve a little bit or they can go straight if you want to. And then if you want to add a couple more short ones going down the side of the jar to show that the fireflies are glowing, you can add a couple more to each of your sides. All right. And that's it. Then your project is all done. Hope you enjoyed painting these watercolor fireflies, Riley, and hope you're doing well.